interpretation or so-called quote-unquote translation of the Quran, and they think this is the Quran. You know, we have this syndrome of going and buying an interpretation according to the linguist who translated the Quran, and we say Allah says this, what Yusuf Ali said. Allah did not say that, that's Yusuf Ali saying, or that's Khan saying, or that's Baghdad saying. That's not what Allah said. But by the way, among the ayahs, الرحمن على العرش استوى. صلى الله عليه وسلم. We have two little things. This ayah is very small. الرحمن على العرش استوى. And people, of course, those who worship idols and they call them Allah, or those who worship an idol and call them Allah, they believe that their Lord, Jalla Jalal, Jalla Jalalullah, their Lord resembles a human being. How? Is not known. But resembles, as consists of organs and limbs, hands, feet, two hands, two feet, knees, hips, lips, cheeks, two eyes, two ears, nose, fingers, digits, you name it. And that he lives in the seventh heaven, sits on the chair, which is the throne, and descends and ascends, or descends and doesn't ascend. Some of them say he doesn't ascend, definitely descends. This kind of idol worshipping philosophy, and that he's limited by the sky, etc., etc., they deduce some of that, according to them, from what Allah says in Quran al-Kareem, Ar-Rahman al-Arsh istawa. Ar-Rahman pertains to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ala means over. Al-Arsh, we don't really know what it means. No one knows really what the Arsh means. The Sunnah does not say what the Arsh means, nor the Quran specifies what the Arsh is. All we can say is what the Arsh is in the linguistic, but is that what Allah meant with it? Allah knows best. That among the meanings of the Arsh, among the meanings of the Arsh, could be the throne. Among the meaning of the Arsh is the kingdom. The entire dominion is Al-Arsh. The Arabs use Al-Arsh as the entire dominion. When the poet says, for example, Fulla Arshu Fulan, which means his dominion is destroyed. They say his throne is destroyed, which means his dominion is destroyed. So the ayah in this sense would be, Allah then istawa on his dominion or over his dominion. What is istawa? Istawa has more than 12 meanings in the Arabic language. Which one Allah meant? Allah knows best. In the Quran, istawa came with 6 different meanings. In the Quran it said, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. ثم استوى إلى السماء فسواهن 7 سماوات. Which means he willed for the creation of heavens, he made making them 7 heavens. And then Allah says, فلما بلغ أشده واستوى. When that young man becomes then adult, it's called استوى. When becoming adult, istawa, reached puberty. Then Allah talks about the ship of Noah, fastawat ala al-judi, started sailing comfortably on the water, istawa. Allah mentions istawa in the sense of comparison, are they equal? قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Are they equal, those who know and those who don't know? So, we have many of these things. Among also, istawa is rose, like some people write. But rose, was Allah below to rise? What is above and below, isn't it the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So, also among the meanings of istawa, the food. When you cook the food, you say istawa al-ta'am, means the food is cooked. Okay, when you, among also the names of istawa, استوى جالسا. When someone sits, that's also called استوى. Now, and Allah also says in Surah Al-Fath, فاستوى على سوقه يعجب الزراع ليغيظ به الكفار. The plants or the little plants, when they fall, they like they kind of stawa, they're kind of leveled, that the farmers like it. That's when they look at it and say it's now ready. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Najm about Jibreel, ذو مرة فاستوى. ذو مرة فاستوى. Now. And which means, ذو مرة means ذو قوة, which means he is powerful and he became clear to view. استوى here. استوى means he was viewable, he was very clear to view. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about استوى في سورة الزخرف لتستووا على ظهوره, which means so you can mount their backs. When you write something, you mount their backs. لتستووا على ظهوره. Now. Allah. So all these things basically are among the meanings of استوى that came in the Quran itself. This word استوى itself. Anthropomorphists or al-mujassima or those who liken Allah to his creation, they leave all these meanings and they take one meaning, which is to sit. Why? Because they're already previously determined that they worship a human being like who sits on a throne. There's no other way. Isn't sitting an attribute of the creation? And didn't Allah says, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ, nothing is like him? Now here's how they philosophize, some of them. They say, well, he sits in a way that suits his majesty. Remember this example? That's like attributing someone with insanity, and you say, it's an insanity that suits your majesty. You're crazy in a way that suits you. After you attribute Allah with imperfection, after you attribute Allah with deficiencies, after you attribute Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with all these things that he's above, should not be attributed with, it doesn't any matter then what you say. Among the meanings of istawa, to subjugate in the Arabic language. To subjugate, to control, to govern. That's also among the meanings of istawa. And the poet, for example, said, فَلَمَّا عَلَوْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ وَاسْتَوَيْنَا جَعَلْنَاهُمْ مَرْعَى النَّسْرًا وَطَائِرِ. The Quran, dear brothers and sisters, came in the Arabic language, not in the Turkish one. Or not in the Russian one. So therefore, the understanding of the Quran must be according to the Arabic rules. Therefore, when the poet says, for example, when we have, at the end of the battle, we became mustawi over them. We subjugated them, we controlled them, we fought them in the battle and we controlled the battle. So that means to subjugate. If we say it that way, linguistically then meaning it could be that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala subjugated the arsh, which is the dominion. He controlled his dominion, subhanahu wa ta'ala, which of course makes sense. Am I saying that this is the meaning Allah meant or willed for? No. Am I saying that this is a possible meaning that could be attributed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Yes. Yes. It is possible that the meaning that Allah subjugated his dominion. Is it possible that we say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sits? Hada kufr. This is blasphemy. As it entails being in a place, space, and likened to the creation. And Allah has nothing like him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the scholars of Tawheed many times, and the scholars of Tafsir, when they interpret these ayahs, if they did, there's two ways to handle these kinds of ayahs, the ayat mutashabihat. Number one is not to interpret them. This is the way of the pious predecessors. Not to interpret them in meaning or in... There's no how, of course. And you cannot say, well, he sits, but I don't know how. That's already attributing what? Imperfection. You're just saying, I don't know the modality. He has a limb, a hand as a limb and an organ, but I don't know how. Well, you've already made him composed of things. doesn't mean how big, how small it, or whatever it is, it doesn't make any difference now. Now, the way of the pious predecessors as manifested by Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala, Imam Shafi'i said this, said, "Amantu bima ja'a anillah ala muradillah." I believe in all what came from Allah as Allah willed and as Allah meant.
This is the beautiful.